The King's Parrot. Once upon a time, there was a rich king who kept a lot of pets. He had lots of pets in his palace. He had lots of pets in his garden. The king especially liked birds. He had a very beautiful parrot. It was red and green and blue and yellow. The parrot also had an extraordinarily thick, curved beak. The parrot had servants of his own. The king told the servants, "Take very good care of my parrot. If anything happens to my parrot, I'll behead all of you." The parrot's servants trembled with fear. They took care of the bird as best as they could. They fed it the best pussy they could find. They never left the bird alone for even a minute. One day, the parrot suddenly flew out of a window and was gone. The servants were terribly frightened. They searched everywhere for the parrot. They searched the palace. They searched the garden. No parrot. Finally, the servants had to tell the king that the parrot was gone. He was very angry. He yelled, "I won't behead you yet. Find the parrot. Go out into the fields. Go out into the forest. Find my parrot." Still trembling, the servants searched every nook and cranny of the kingdom for a month. They did not find the parrot. The servants went back to the king, "Oh, glorious king of the world," said the chief servant. "Where's my parrot?" asked the king. "Oh, glorious king of the world," repeated the servants. "Stop the frenzy," said the king. "Where's my parrot? Where's my parrot?" "We can't find it, your majesty," said the chief servant. The king was furious. He said, "This is your last chance. Go find my parrot." The servants ran out of the palace. They began the search again. They searched and searched. They were just about ready to give up when they met an old lady. The old lady was feeding a parrot. It was the parrot they were looking for. Something was wrong, though. The parrot's beak was bleeding. It had been cut. Surprisingly enough, the parrot was enjoying his food. Still, the servants were worried. "If we return with this bleeding bird, the king will behead us," they cried. They decided to take the old lady with them before the king. The chief servant bowed to the old lady. "Come, madam, come to the palace with us." They all walked back to the palace. When they got there, the chief guard announced them. "The parrot and its servants are back," announced the guard. "Bring them in," said the king. They are marched in. The chief servant said, "Here's your parrot, oh glorious king of the world." "This old lady had it, but look," cried the king. "Its beak is bleeding. What's wrong with it? What have you done to my parrot?" "Oh glorious king of the world," said the old lady. "When I found this parrot, its beak was too thick and crabbed. It could not enjoy its food, so I trained its beak. Now the parrot can enjoy its food." So the king realized that the old lady carried about the bird with her whole heart. She was different from his useless servant. "Wonderful," exclaimed the king. "I appointed you loyal keeper of the parrot. You will live here at the palace forever, and I shall pay you a huge amount of money every month." "Please," said the old lady, "don't cut off the servants." As they tried hard and they did find the parrot, the king agreed not to cut off the servants' heads, and everyone lived happily ever after.
Okay, very nice.